Hi there. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the Gauss-Markov assumptions in econometrics and what their significance is. So the Gauss-Markov assumptions are a set of criteria which were first created by mathematicians Carl Friedrich Gauss and Andrei Markov, which if they are upheld, then that says something about our ability to use least squared estimates or least squared estimators on the sample data. Well, it says that those least squared estimators are in fact blue. But what does it mean for an estimator to be blue? Well, it means that there are no other linear unbiased estimators which have a lower sampling variance than that particular estimator. So I can illustrate this graphically. Imagine that I have a sampling distribution of one estimator which looks like that, and then I have another one which has the same sort of center as the first one, except it is slightly steeper towards the actual center of the distribution. So assuming that both of these are unbiased, so they're both centered around the true population parameter, we can see that the second estimator has a lower sampling variance than the first. Well, that means that more often than not, when I use my least squared estimators, when I apply my least squared estimators to the sample data, they are going to more often than not provide me with estimates of the true population parameter, beta p, which are closer to beta p than I would have got from using the first type of estimator. So that's the sort of significance in econometrics about the Gauss-Markov assumptions. But what are the Gauss-Markov assumptions? There's no particular order to the Gauss-Markov assumptions, but I'm going to sort of label them here so that means that I can refer to them in the future. The first Gauss-Markov assumption has to do with the population process. So assuming that there is some population process which connects wages with number of years of education, education doesn't exactly determine wages because there's some sort of error term here. This is an example of a model which is linear in parameters. So that means that it's linear in alpha and beta. So this is what we want. This is the first Gauss-Markov assumption, which says that our population process has to be linear in parameters. Note that this type of model, where if I had sort of wages being equal to alpha times beta times the number of years of education plus alpha times, just alpha on its own, this would be non-linear in parameters because this has got some sort of multiplicative effect between alpha and beta. So, or if I had sort of beta squared here, that would also be non-linear in parameters. Note, however, that linear in parameters doesn't mean that I cannot have a variable in our model which is nonlinear. So actually having education squared in our model rather than just education, that is perfectly fine under the assumption of linearity in parameters. It just means that I cannot have a model which has nonlinear parameters within it. Brilliant. So that's the first Markov condition. The second condition is that we have a set of a sample data, xi and yi, which are a random sample from the population. So what does that actually mean? Well, it means that within our population, it's a random sample occurs if each individual in the population is equally likely to be picked when I take the sample. So that's what we mean by a random sample. But it also implicitly means that not only are every individual in the population equally likely to be picked, it means that all of our data points come from the same population. So they come from the same population process, which in this context might be sort of wages being equal to alpha plus beta times education plus some error. The third condition is perhaps the most important of the Gauss-Markov conditions, which is the zero conditional mean of errors. So what does this actually mean? Well, mathematically, it means that the expectation of our error term in our population, given our x term, which in this case would be education, is going to be equal to zero. But what does that actually mean practically? Well, it means that if I know someone's level of education, that does not help me to predict whether they will be above or below the average sort of population regression line. So that's what it means for there to be a zero conditional mean of error. And this is perhaps the most important of the Gauss-Markov assumptions, for reasons which we'll come onto later. So that concludes our sort of first video looking into the Gauss-Markov assumption. I'm going to, in the next video, explain the next three Gauss-Markov assumptions.